The next exercise is to simulate with a traffic demand. A traffic demand is an object that contains the demand for a model. The demand can either be represented as a traffic state or as a set of origin-destination matrices. In this exercise, we're going to create two traffic demands, one to contain the traffic state we created earlier, and the second one to contain the two matrices created afterwards. In the scenario which runs the model, we will select which one to use. So I will create two traffic demands by selecting Project, New, Demand Data, Traffic Demand. I can duplicate this object, empty traffic demand, by dragging it to the traffic demand folder. So first, I will rename the first traffic demand to Traffic Demand Matrix by double-clicking on the traffic demand object. I will set up the initial time from 8 a.m. and duration of 1 hour. I will click Add Demand Item and select the car AM and the track AM OD matrices. I will click OK, and this is how I created a traffic demand based on origin destination matrices. Now I will open the other traffic demand object. I will give it another name, Traffic Demand States, and I will also set initial time 8 a.m. and duration 1 hour. Now I will change the type of the matrices to be states, and I will add a demand item, and then click OK. So to test the geometry that we have created up until now, we can run an initial simulation, even though we have still to specify the signal control plans and the public transportation. To do this, we need to create a scenario and an experiment. To create a scenario, we go again to the menu bar, Project, New, Scenarios, Create a Dynamic Scenario. Add a new dynamic scenario. Next, I will create an experiment associated with this scenario. To do this, I will right-click on the scenario and select New Experiment. Set the experiment type to Macroscopic Simulator and Stochastic Route Choice. I will double-click on the dynamic scenario and select the traffic demand of the OD matrices that I have created. We won't review the experiment's features in this exercise. However, if we want to run the simulation, we must create a replication. So all these are the options that need to be revised before we run a simulation. And to generate one replication object, I will just need to right-click on the experiment object and then create new replication. I won't create any average, I will just need one run. In order to create more replications, I need to create an average so that it can sum up and process the simulation results later on. Next, I will right-click on the replication and choose Run Animated Simulation Autorun. At this point, we can try starting and stopping the simulation and changing its speed and smoothness with the two slider option of the simulation control bar. So this bar is being presented since the simulation has started, and I can see that I can pause the simulation, I can fast forward the simulation, I can go step by step, I can change the smoothness and the simulation speed by clicking on this bar, and of course I can have information about the outputs real time of the simulation. How many vehicles are waiting to enter, are inside, outside, have been lost, already lost outside of my network. I can also set up a simulation stop point where my simulation I want to stop. So I will set up at 8:35 my simulation to stop. Fast forward and the simulation has stopped at 8:35 exactly. I can also record a video of this simulation by just clicking on this button. To check where the video is being stored, you can go to Edit, Preferences, Microsimulator, and see where the output folder of this video has been set up, as well as other video recording settings. To finish the simulation, I can press Fast Forward, and then the replication dialog of the simulation output summary and some other information about the path assignment outputs is being displayed here. To close the simulation, I just need to press the cross in the simulation dialog here and make sure that the view mode drop-down menu above the map is back to none.